Welcome to our media production plan, composed in the style of a Draw My Life video. Our group is made up of Laura, Kirsty, Rhianne, and myself, Duncan. I shall detail the roles that each of us took on later on in this video. Our task involved us creating a group of 3 to 4 people with a view to making a viral social media campaign for a company or person of our choice. What we didn't realise was that choosing our client was going to prove to be the hardest part. We spent countless hours pondering and playing with ideas ranging from bands to independent cake makers and vintage clothing shops, but simply couldn't find anything that we thought we could have a big enough influence in. So a week of pondering went by and we finally decided against pursuing a client and concluded that letting the client come to us would be the better idea. Kirsty made use of her large number of followers and tweeted offering help with social media marketing to anybody who needed or wanted it, as opposed to approaching a company and persuading them that they needed our help. This proved to be a clever option and we found a client who was amazingly easy to work with and brought the best in us all out by creating an enjoyable, friendly working atmosphere for us all. Several people replied to Kirsty, and all of a sudden we had a decision to make. Which one would we choose? We had replies from bands and t-shirt designers and one standout reply from a graphic designer in Essex, but we eventually decided against it due to several problems that we could see arising in the distance. The main problem being that the campaign would lose its personal touch as we would struggle to travel to and from Essex for meetings as a result of us having the limited funds notorious with student life and also having quite busy working lives outside of university. It was then that Scott Anderson, a DJ from Aberdeen associated with the Home Alone Aberdeen group, replied with a simple, "Help us," instantly capturing our attention. We proceeded to arrange a meeting with Scott to introduce ourselves and spitball some ideas, learning what he already had in terms of social media presence, and also discovering what we could offer him within our time frame. Upon hearing our ideas, Scott seemed extremely enthusiastic and interested, and we all knew that it would be a fruitful partnership. We learned that Scott and several other DJs wanted to hold a unique pub or club music night, the prospective venue being Cellar 35. Agreeing to help with the social media campaign, we set the date of the pub night to be the 8th of April. Originally we had planned to hold the night on a weekend, but availability of venues proved to be a problem, and we settled with the 8th. Following our meeting, we decided that we would assist Scott by using Facebook and Twitter as our main platforms, as it suits the target audience which he described to us as simply being students, as that is his usual target. We felt that this was perfect for a social media project, as Facebook and Twitter have large amounts of students as their users. As social media followings are easily measurable, we decided to set ourselves a couple of aims or goals. Currently, the Home Alone Aberdeen group use a Facebook and Twitter as well as a website, which we are aware is not 100% for purpose, but will be looked at in the future. In terms of Twitter followers, Home Alone Aberdeen stand at a number of 435, a number which we will increase to 600 before the final night. Similarly, Home Alone Aberdeen have 572 likes on their Facebook account, which we will turn into 700 likes during the promotion period. In terms of content creation and what we want to base the main viral promotion around, we decided that we would make a documentary surrounding Scott and his fellow DJs. This documentary would aim to differentiate Scott and other DJs from the relatively anonymous DJs that operate in all the mainstream local clubs. We will talk to the DJs about their experiences as being DJs and why they got started, as well as their love for music, including particular styles that any of them have encapsulated in their work. The documentary will showcase the type of music that will be played on the night, creating an interest in the music and the people providing it instead of the usual club, drink and then home atmosphere. The main aim would be to create a more personal atmosphere for people to be involved in. We want the audience to have an insight into the styles and personalities of the DJs. The documentary will be worked on during the month of March before being uploaded on YouTube before April comes about. We will be working to a 25th of March deadline for this particular piece of work to give us enough time to plan the release at the start of April. That leaves us the week leading up to the event to share it and promote the event using the documentary as our main promotion tool. The documentary will gain views on YouTube and be shared amongst friends and their friends to create an exponential growth in views and spark a large interest in the event, which would then lead to higher attendance and a successful night for everybody. We will record the event and produce a highlight video from the night to post as evidence of the turnout and also ask Scott to give us a few words on how he thinks the night went. This will also be posted on our blog, which we have used and will use throughout the project to document our progress. We chose a blog as our medium for tracking our progress and submitting our plan, as it quite simply looks nicer than a bundle of monochrome paper and linear reporting of planned events. We aim to have fun during this project as well as create a quality piece of work, and therefore encourage each other to let our personality shine through in the writing on the blog as opposed to keeping it strictly formal. It is also a great tool for group work as we can all access it relatively easy and post when we want, keeping the work in the draft stage until the rest of the group have confirmed that the post should be published. This keeps all of our work centralised, which is key for the four of us, as we all have pretty busy lives. Following the campaign, we will have time to evaluate how we did, and we will take our blog to do this. We can start off by firstly comparing our expected Facebook likes and Twitter followers to the actual amount obtained at the end of the campaign. We will also be able to see how many have liked, shared, and watched our YouTube documentary. Before setting out to start our project plan, we decided to assign ourselves roles so we could better understand what each person would bring to the table in the long run. Following discussion, we agreed that Laura would be in charge of keeping our blog up to date with the latest posts, which will be submitted as part of our plan but also continue throughout the project to document what we get up to as a group in the lead up to our final submission. She will also take charge of our campaign from the Facebook perspective and provide assistance with audio when recording our final product. Already, Laura has assisted greatly in the creation of our Blackboard Draw My Lifestyle presentation. Laura and Rian also formed a great partnership in the composing of our blog posts up to this stage. We agreed that Rian would assist with the creative sides of the project, most importantly scripting the documentary, lending her skills as a previous journalism student to help with the direction of the film and to decide what content should be included within it. Kirsty will be at the helm of the Twitter side of things, making frequent posts in the lead up to us releasing our film, which will promote the night shortly after. This will make sure that we remain in the minds of those who have followed us and to keep people looking forward to our final product. Kirsty will lend her creative and design skills to the group and will keep up formal contact with our client to update him on our progress and to make sure that all dates and times are concrete. As there has to be an insanely large amount of communication between us and our client, we decided that this was one of the most important roles and that Kirsty would take it up perfectly. And finally, we decided that I would take up the responsibility of filming as I have the equipment at home that we would need to use for our film. I have also taken up the role of project leader and will be in charge of making sure that we meet our deadlines as well as general group organisation and overseeing everyone's tasks and making sure that we all remain on task throughout the coursework.